We're in the studio with Hatim Belyamani and Tyler Woods, who recorded this incredible music in Morocco.
So the native population of North Africa and some parts of Sub-Saharan Africa are referred to as Berbers, but the name that they give to themselves is Amazigh, which means the free people. Mm. And so there's a number of different Amazigh traditions in Morocco, and I've been particularly interested in Amazigh culture in Morocco because there's been a recent opening up politically, socially, and culturally. And part of it was accelerated by the so-called Arab Spring. After the most significant events of the Arab Spring in 2011, the Moroccan king came out and gave a speech, and the speech showed his resolve to make some significant changes to Moroccan democracy, and he called for a new constitution, and a new constitution was written up in July of that year. And for the first time, the language of the Amazigh people was recognized as an official language. Some of the musicians that we recorded, notably the main percussion soloist, who was playing this badass solo at the end, he and a couple of the other musicians are regularly performing with the most famous singer of this style of music. And she is a very vocal activist. And she's done something that is pretty extraordinary. She went to the parliament a couple years ago after the constitution had stated that the Amazigh language is now officially recognized. She went to parliament and for the first time asked a question in her native Amazigh tongue. And the parliament got shaken up a little bit. Some people were, applauding. Other people were booing. And it caused an instant debate. And the question that she asked was very relevant. She asked, okay, so we have this official recognition of our language, but the Constitution required certain laws to be passed to put it into effect and to ensure that it is taught in our schools, etc. And so she asked what is being done to ensure that this right that has been given by the Constitution, what is being done to ensure that it goes into effect? And she asked that question in the Amazigh language, and some of the parliament members didn't understand her question. And that's exactly the point that she was trying to prove. And as a result of that, they now have a budget for translating Amazigh language questions in parliament. There are a lot of other changes in Morocco. Now it's a very common part of the public landscape to see the Amazigh script. They don't use the same script as Arabic or French. And so now most storefronts, not most, but an increasing number of storefronts and institutions have French, Arabic, and now Tifinagh. Tifinagh is their script.
Sounds like you're telling me that something good is actually happening in the world.
Absolutely.
Some progress.
Absolutely, absolutely, yes. And in general, Morocco has invested a lot more energy and money on promoting all the different types of traditional music. So that's very encouraging to see. And we hope to see more of that. And I'm excited to be a part of that wave in Morocco.